Now we're going to see the paraboloid. The paraboloid has the equation. Paraboloid has the equation x squared divided by a squared plus y squared divided by b squared equals c divided by c. This is the example of this paraboloid. I'm going to explain this in detail and then we're going to change the form of the parabola. Alright, so as you can see, it looks like a parabola. So if we think in the x squared divided by a squared plus y squared divided by b squared equals, let's say, 0, this means if we do a cross section in the xy plane, that is this, that is c is equal to 0, that is we're doing a cross section in the c equals 0 plane, that is the xy plane. If we do this cut section, actually we are not cutting nothing because we are just touching the tip of this parabola. But if we, instead of putting c equals 0, let's put c naught, that is above, so we are cutting through a plane that is parallel to the xy plane, so it's like this, and if you see it, you cut like this and you see what you have. This is a ellipse, is this ellipse that I drew. So this ellipse would be, so x squared divided by a squared plus y squared divided by b squared equals c naught divided by c, that is just a number. So it is a ellipsoid, is a ellipse in which the semi-axis are a and b. If you see, these are the semi-axis in y, that is this, here is b, and in x, here you have a, and here you have a. And this point is indicating the c, could be the c in which we are cutting the, or taking the cross of the parabola. If you see, this is the point c, all this distance is the point c. Alright, so if you cross section in the c plane, that is in the xy plane, or c equals c naught, you have ellipses with axis a, semi-axis a and b. And if you put c equals 0, so you do exactly in the xy plane, the other was in the a xy parallel plane, but so if you cut in the xy plane, this c naught is 0. And so you have x squared divided by a squared plus y squared divided by b squared equals 0. The only case in which this can be true is when x and y are both 0, because both of these are squared, so both are going to be a positive number, so there is no number that added to another number be different than 0, so only 0 can satisfy this equation. So that means that when c is equal to 0, x and y are equal to 0, and so we are just in the tip of this parabola. So if you cross in the xy plane, exactly the xy plane, or you can say in the c equals 0 plane, you would only see a point, that is the origin, in this case is the origin. Alright, now, as you see, it looks like parabolas. You have two axes of symmetry that are in the xc plane and in the yc plane. So you could say in the y equals, in this case I would put y equals 0, and here I would put x equals 0. So we have two planes. In the plane xy, x is in this dimension and C is in this dimension, so you have this plane. So if you cut the parabola in this plane, you will see a parabola. So in the xz plane, that is in the y equals 0 plane, you have the equation x squared divided by a squared, this is 0, equals c divided by c. So you have c is equal to c x squared divided by a squared. These are just constant, and you see you have c equals x squared, that is a parabola in the plane xz. Now if you have the yz plane, so you cut, this is y and this is c, you're cutting through here, you're going to see a parabola. So again, now because x is 0, you have y squared equals y squared divided by b squared is equal to c over c. So again, c is equal to y squared divided by b squared times c. Again, c divided by b squared is just a constant. And so you just have c equals some constant, c2, y squared. So you have a parabola in the cy plane, in which it's open through the c-axis. He also was open in the c-axis, like in this plane you have it, but it's open in the c-axis. Here you have a parabola that is open in the c-axis. Alright, so the paraboloid has two axes of symmetry. When you do cross sections through the planes that contain the axis at which the parabolas are open. In this example, is if you do cross section through the xz plane and yz plane, you have ellipses. You have parabolas. And if you do cross section in the axis that is perpendicular to the axis in which the parabolas are opening, so you have ellipses just in the point at which c, or the plane is c equals 0, you have just a point that is 0, 0, 0. If you want to move this paraboloid, you can move, for example, here instead of having, let's say, y squared, you can have y minus 2 squared. And so it's the same, just that would be translated minus 2 in the y direction. Or like that, you can move that around. The other issue is if you want to invert this, you would put instead of x squared plus x squared divided by a squared plus y squared divided by b squared equals c divided by c, you change the signs like this. So now you have minus x squared divided by a squared minus y squared divided by b squared, and now it is dropping water. This parabola is now dropping water, and you can move it here or you can put it here. It depends now on the initial conditions that you have here in the x, in the y, or in the c. The other issue is here we are seeing a paraboloid that is opening through the c-axis, could be opening here, opening downwards in the c-axis, but you can also have paraboloids that open in the x direction, or in the y direction. So you can have a paraboloid, let's say, again, this is the C plane, let's say Y plane and X plane. You can have a paraboloid like this that opens, let's say, through the X axis. And so that this paraboloid has the form y square divided by b square plus c square divided by c square equals x divided by a. Summing around this. And the same for if you want a paraboloid in the y, you would have that is opening in the through the y axis would be y divided by b is equal to x squared divided by a plus c squared divided by c squared. If you want that be in y direction but in the let's say in the opposite direction, then you put minus and minus. So these are the paraboloids. The paraboloid has two axes of symmetry. And the cross section that contains the or through the planes that contains the axis in which the paraboloid are opening in this case was the CX plane and the CY plane. The cross sections that you got are parabolas, and if you do cross sections perpendicular to the axis at which the paraboloid is opening, you have ellipses just at the tip of the paraboloid, you have a point.